This is freedom. This is a tough song to talk about because it's very, very personal for me. But I remember my publisher setting me up to write with Sarah Hart. And I have to admit, as a new songwriter, I was scared to death. Sarah Hart is an incredible writer, and she was just coming off the heels of the latest Amy Grant hit, Better Than Hallelujah, of which I was a total fan. And so I was very nervous going into write with Sarah that day. I barely slept the night before because I was trying to think of some brilliant song idea that I could bring in that day, and absolutely nothing came to me. And I was driving to EMI that day to write with her, just praying, Lord, please give me something brilliant that's going to change people's lives and really make an impact and really reveal, you know, you to them. And as I walked into the room that day, I still didn't have a title idea, which made me even more nervous. But the minute I met Sarah, we were like old friends, and she was so kind and so welcoming. And so most of the time in the songwriting room, you sit there for sometimes a couple of hours just getting to know each other and telling your stories. And as we talked that day and told each other our stories, God revealed over coffee exactly what we were supposed to write that day. And so I look back now and I realize that God showed up right on time, just like he always does. And as we were talking, we you know, just talked about the freedom that we have found in Christ and the peace that we have knowing that he gave the ultimate sacrifice so that we could be free. And this song was born that day. She started playing that intro part that sounded almost hymn-like to me. And I'm kind of a sucker for old hymns, and so I immediately gravitated towards the idea and loved it. And to be honest, it's difficult for me to sing this song without getting choked up, because I was the girl that wandered for a long time on a broken road, and I definitely felt bruised and battered at times and not sure how to carry on. But when I finally let go of the guilt of my yesterdays and allowed God's grace to cover my tomorrows, I found the freedom that he longs to give all of us if we'll just accept it. It's the greatest gift of all. And the coolest thing is that we have been given the freedom to choose it. That's all we have to do. So I hope that you'll choose Jesus and allow him into your life and to love you beyond anything you've ever experienced. It's the freedom that he wants to give us all. But the best part is that it's not a temporary freedom. It's for eternity. And this is freedom. Oh, blessed freedom. This is freedom for eternity.